health system. But we begin today with the Archbishop's response to the St. Aug community over the paddling controversy. St. Aug is in favor of it. The Archbishop is not. WDSU News reporter Gina Swanson is live this afternoon in the 7th Ward. School leaders met with the Archbishop yesterday. Gina, what's he have to say today?
That's right, Scott. Not much activity here at St. Augustine High School because the students are on spring break, but the discussions about the school's discipline policy certainly have been ongoing. Today, the Archbishop wrote an open letter to the St. Augustine community, and he laid out a few different things. First, he wanted to apologize for any inference that he had linked the school's discipline policy of paddling to the violence in New Orleans. He made a public apology for that, and he said that he wanted to retract those statements. He went on to say that he was hoping to resolve this issue in a more quiet fashion, but he wants to honor the St. Augustine community request for transparency. He also provided them with a report that actually raised his concerns and is the reason that the ban was put in place in the first place. But he has committed to continue discussions on the policy, but still no resolution at this point, Scott.
I've heard his side. What does the school say to the Archbishop's response today?
Their St. Augustine leaders also put out a statement today. They say that they are actually reviewing this report that they were provided with yesterday, and they do say that they are glad that the Archdiocese and Archbishop Gregory Aymond has committed to continue this discussion, but still no resolution.
All right, so where does this go from here?
The leaders did tell us that they do plan to have yet another meeting about this. We know there was a 3-hour meeting yesterday. At the end of February, there was a 4-hour meeting with all the stakeholders. Yet they want to have another meeting coming up to keep discussing this further. But the Archbishop says that he really wants to do this in a spirit of healing. He's actually offered to come and celebrate Mass for the people in the St. Augustine community. And he says he's looking forward to putting this divide behind them. That's the very latest for now. We're on your side. I'm Gina Swanson. Back to you.
All right.